Hey guys, this is David Kwan here, here to talk about OctoDad. And this game is just so wacky and so weird and quirky. And yet, I'm so glad that a game like this is in development and a game like this will exist in the gaming landscape. I think this is what kind of like gaming should have, these kinds of crazy games. It shouldn't always be about the games that, you know, are traditional games or platforming games or games that feel realistic or whatever. This kind of crazy game should exist as well. And OctoDad, it really surprised me when it was first revealed in the Sony press conference this year. I was just like, whoa, wait, what the heck was that? Like, I need to learn more about that game because it's just so wacky. It is this octopus who is dressed up in human clothes walking around. I mean, is that it? Is that the gameplay? What kind of gameplay does this game have? Like, why would I find that exciting? And yet, I found myself drawn to it because it's so weird and quirky. The premise is an interesting one. You're an octopus, but you're in human society, and no one suspects a thing. No one knows that you're an octopus, even though you can clearly say that it's an octopus. Anyway, you're living out your life trying to be like a human in a human society, and your job in the entire game is to not be discovered, so that no one actually discovers that you're not a human being, you're an octopus. And I think the first level of this game, judging from the coverage, is you're being married to this wife. And it's a human wife. She's a red-haired, pretty girl, and you are to get your tuxedo, find your tie, find your hat, and get to the wedding ceremony. It's pretty simple, right? Just get to the wedding ceremony. In any other game, that would not be such a thing, such a big deal. But because you're an octopus in this game, the controls are intentionally cumbersome and intentionally, I guess, there's going to be a line between, and the developers talked about, you know, there's a fine, the challenge is to keep this balance between, well, if the game is too hard to control, then it's frustrating and annoying. But if the game is too easy, then it's kind of boring because you're just walking around the place doing ordinary things like finding a tie, dressing up, and doing ordinary tasks in modern life. You know, cooking dinner or whatever. Very boring things to do if the controls are too easy, but if the controls are too hard, then it just gets too frustrating. So they have to find this middle ground between either too frustrating or too boring. So that's the challenge. Controls are intentionally cumbersome because you're controlling each limb or the leg of the octopus. To move forward, you hold the L2 or the R2. L2, when you hold it down, you move the left leg, and so you use the analog stick along with the left L2. To move the right leg, you hold down R2. To move the right arm, you hold down R1, and then you move your arms that way. So it's kind of that method. If you think of Little Big Planet and how you move your arms around, kind of like that, I think. But that's really the concept. You're trying to keep your cover as an octodad, as an octopus living inside human society as a father. I think it's really quirky, really interesting, and if they manage to really perfect that balance between not frustrating and not boring, in this little quirky little premise they got, I think they got something really exciting, really interesting here. And of course, it's a downloadable indie game, so I do expect it to be really cheap. I don't know, I think $15 would be pushing it for a game like this, but if it's priced at like $10 or $7, could be really big. I think it could be really successful title. It looks fun. It looks quirky. I'm glad that this game exists, and I find myself actually excited for a game like this, even though I know it's a pretty simple game, and the only reason that it would actually be fun is because the controls are intentionally cumbersome. But yeah, I'm excited to see how this game turns out, definitely. So yeah. Thanks for watching. Cheers.